This video will introduce you to matrix coding queries. Matrix coding queries are a very basic form of cross-tabulation within NVivo, allowing you to look at three different attributes of data. While they are ultimately a quantitative expression of findings within your project, they can be used as shortcuts to access qualitative in-depth information. They're really useful for surveys and for quick glances across your data. Let's look at one of these in practice so we can explore it in more detail. Start off by going to the Explore ribbon and then choose Matrix Coding Query. The Matrix Coding Query criteria will open in Detail View. First of all, let's start by setting the scope of our query. I'm going to search in, choose Selected Folders, and Open Files to tick Interviews. This means this query will only be based on data within the interviews. I now need to add row items. I'm going to click plus and choose select items. I'm then going to select the codes folder and open up economy to choose agriculture, fishing or aquaculture, jobs and the cost of living, and tourism, and then click OK. For the columns, I'm going to click on plus and choose select items. I'm going to select the codes folder, open attitude and select mixed, negative, neutral and positive, and then click OK. You'll see the order of these doesn't really make sense, so I'm going to click positive and use the arrow here to move it to the top. Positive, mixed, negative, neutral. This looks much better. Now that we've fully specified all of the criteria, I'm going to click Run Query. This matrix is showing all of the coding to agriculture, fishing or aquaculture, jobs and the cost of living, and tourism, and where they overlap with coding to positive, mixed, negative, and neutral sentiment. I can use cell shading at the top to make this a little easier to explore. For green, yellow, red shading, green is used to indicate large numbers and red smaller numbers. As this is exploring both positive and negative, this kind of colour doesn't make sense in this context, so I'm just going to use the blue to white shading. You'll see at the moment that this matrix is currently just showing coding references. That is, how many times do coding references overlap based on this criteria? This kind of number is an imperfect expression of the rich data in this particular project. A coding reference could be a single word, an entire paragraph, or an entire source. So I'm going to switch the measure from coding references to words coded. You'll see here there's a slight change in how we perceive the results. We can see there's a lot more comments about negative attitudes to fishing or aquaculture than was first viewable when looking at coding references alone. This is an important demonstration of why you need to be careful when interpreting coding references. The most powerful thing about a matrix coding query, however, is your ability to explore this in greater detail. If I double click on any of these cells, such as this one here, to explore jobs and the cost of living and negative attitude, it will run a coding query to find where those two overlap. And here I can explore those textual references in detail. This is a really useful thing when you're writing up. It's important to note that the matrix coding query is not just limited to cross-tabulating codes. Indeed, one of the powers of this compared to the cross-tab query itself is your ability to bring in different items into your matrix. In this example, I've actually brought in the source files, these interviews with Barbara, Betty, Paul, Charles, Daniel, and so on. And in my columns, I've brought all of the codes to do with fishing industry decline. If I run this query, I can very quickly and numerically explore the coding to fishing industry decline for each of the interview participants. This is a very quick way of numerically exploring this, and it also gives me access to double click on any of these cells to explore the references in more detail. While not covered in this video, It's important to note that you've also got the option to add attribute values. This enables you to bring data in based on all of your file and case classifications. This can be an interesting way for you to explore your data in further detail. If you like this kind of visualization, you'll also see you can use the chart tab here to view a visual representation of this. Just like any of these visualizations in NVivo, they can be tweaked using the contextual ribbons at the top, and they can be exported by right-clicking and choose Export Chart. Remember, this is a numerical expression of data, and it's probably not a good way for me to visualize the richness of these interviews. However, were I using this to explore a vast quantity of data in a survey, this would be a really good way to get a quick overview of what topics came up the most often. Now it's time for you to think about how you can use this in your research.